Good morning and welcome to Let It Heal Live. My name is Renee Delaney. I'm going to be hosting this morning with Amy McBeth.
Hello.
Hi. We're going to turn the tables around a little bit today. Amber's with us via Skype. Normally she's hosting, only today we're going to be the ones asking her the questions. So we're going to talk about the Bowen technique, that is rightfully so, because I have many questions as well. I've been working at Let It Heal for just under a year now, I guess, as the homeopath at all of the locations, pretty much. But I still don't have the proper way to explain to people what it is. What I say when people ask me, what is Bowen, I say, it's something that really has amazing results.
There's a bit more to it than that.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm going to be the one asking most of the questions, as you can imagine. Maybe you could give us a little bit better of a definition than this really
probably
works.
I've never done the Bowen. I don't have any anatomy courses or anything very impressive behind me, but I have worked in a clinic, so I certainly spent enough time explaining to people like a rough overview of what it does. Basically, it's a technique of teaching the body to heal itself. So the body's healing itself from within. You're finding ways to eliminate medicines, and I mean, there's still lots of exercise that goes along with it. There's, you know, learning how to look after your body.
Right.
But the work is actually done from the inside, like your brain sending out signals throughout the body.
Right.
And your body taking those signals and correcting problems.
Along the lines of most natural
absolutely,
healing, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, they say
but it's done in such a relaxing way that you quite literally almost fall asleep while your hour-long treatment is being done. It's
right. I've had the treatment.
Yeah, I totally faked a few injuries just so I could have the Bowen done. And it was like a way to say to my husband and family, I need to go away for this treatment for an hour. And I was just faking it.
Yeah, I felt the same way. The more that I went, the more I wanted to go. However, I no longer had any ailments.
Yeah.
I just felt like it was such a good
experience. Well,
it was
always a nice environment too, but
yeah. Yeah, and the ladies that we're going to be speaking with today are also...
they know a lot more about it than, anyone,
and they're a joy
really
to be around. So you find that when you end up going to a clinic, you want to talk to them just as much. So we're going to get a little experience with that today. What we're going to do is we actually have Amber and Tiffany with us. Tiffany is Amber's sister. They both mostly work out of the Burlington location, I imagine.
Yeah, I think they do their share of traveling, but for the most part, Burlington's home.
Burlington's home, yeah. I know that there's five clinics, is there?
That sounds right. Kitchener, St. Catharines,
Dundas, Toronto.
And Burlington. And Burlington being the first.
Yeah, and Amber being the founder of the clinics, correct?
Yeah, she has a very good story how she became who she is, so we'll let her tell that story.
That'll be interesting to go through. So you've had the Bowen treatment yourself?
I have. I've actually had it done on my knees.
On your knees. What was wrong? What was going on there?
Just... I don't actually know how to describe what was wrong, other than my knees hurt.
Okay.
Just going up and down stairs was ridiculously painful, and I was starting to whine a lot about it. So they pretty much threw me in a bed and just said, do it. And I think initially it was four treatments. And when I knew I was fixed was I'd gone to San Francisco. And if you're going to pick any city in the world to test your knees, that is probably the best one. And sure enough, it was fantastic.
And how did you hear about the clinics? How did you hear about Let It Heal?
I've actually known Amber for a few years. We've known each other before she ever became who she is.
Right.
But I worked with her years ago and Tiffany as well. I've known them all for years.
So I imagine they were like, you got to try this.
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Okay, so why don't we start the real questions? We'll get Amber on with us through Skype. How are you doing today, Amber?
Hi, there good. How are you?
You look all nice and warm and enjoying yourself.
You don't look like you're at a conference in England.
No. We tried. We really did.
Yeah.
I think maybe if we'd hung in there, we might have actually made it to the conference, but there was just too much uncertainty about whether we were going to end up making it back home again.
Right.
That was our concern. So, you know, like between us, we've got six children and lots of clients that we try to see on a weekly basis. So it was hard enough to get away for a week. But, oh well, Cancun's a pretty good alternative option.
You're not too upset about that, I can see.
Not too upset. Hang on just a second. I'm going to show you guys something. Look what they have. You guys know what I drink usually, right?
Oh, there she has it.
It's like...
What is it?
It's fresh, though. Like, I have to... It's
she's a juicer
it's
queen.
Dung cactus leaves, spinach, celery, parsley, and orange juice made fresh every day.
And no vodka?
Like, no, not yet.
Okay.
We did joke about that.
Well, I can't.
It's
go to
only
camp
10 o'clock in the morning here.
Wow, still sounds like you're pretty much in heaven there with your juicing.
I know, like it was the one thing that I knew that I was really going to miss. Like, I know that they always have the fresh tropical juices here and stuff like that, but I like my green stuff and even the vegetables, like on the buffets and stuff. It's really, it's very easy to eat healthy here and all the fish and stuff like that. So I'm absolutely thrilled. And so is Tiffany. We're having a blast. Is the sound quality okay? Are you guys having a hard time with all the background noise?
No, I think we're okay.
Do I want to know what the noise
good.
Is?
Oh, geez, no, it's someone walking by with a cart right now. We were going to do it outside, but I was a little worried about all of the pool activities and stuff like that and the wind. And at some point, there might be a bunch of people that walk by and decide to have a very loud, drunken conversation behind us, so I might have to. Seems to happen around here quite a bit. So anyway, we're talking about Bowen. I heard some of your conversation and your experiences with Bowen. And obviously, I've got tons of things to say about Bowen, too. And seeing as that's the topic, that's how we can start off, I
Perfect.
Guess. Yeah?
Yeah, well, we were...
Is Patty joining us?
Sorry. I was just explaining that I don't ever have a really proper way of explaining exactly what it is. I don't have the words down well enough to say, this is Bowen, this is the exact technique, and this is exactly what it does. So we were going to leave that to you to get down right to business.
That's what I do best, and there will be a quiz at the end, so listen carefully. It's hard to explain Bowen, because people, like I'll meet people, you know, at social events or at networking events, whatever, and they'll go, so what do you do? And I used to cop out in the beginning and just say, oh, I'm in massage, because it gives people kind of an idea, and you don't have to get too technical, but that doesn't help spread the word about Bowen. So I found that I needed to learn how to explain what I do in a couple of sentences, right?
Right.
And then if people are interested, they're gonna ask more questions and say, really, wow, how does that work? Or what does it involve? So, I mean, my quick description of Bowen would be that it's just a very gentle, soft tissue work that activates the body's central nervous system and enables healing of pretty much anything that ails you, whether it be pain, digestive issues, breathing problems, that about summarizes it, right? And then of course, oh, wow, the next question would be, how on earth does that work and what does it entail?
Do tell.
So, do tell. You're hanging on the edge of your seat. Anyway, so it's complicated. It's a very, very precise sort of a treatment where my job is really easy as long as I do it well.
Okay.
And as it happens, I do it really well, so I don't have any problems.
Well, there you go.
But you've got to know, you've got to be able to, focus. And once you're in tune and you can feel how the people's muscles are responding and whatnot, you're able to locate the precise spots where we need to just basically stress the muscle. So if I've got a muscle and it's going this way, I need to stretch it the other way, the way that it shouldn't normally go. And that's what activates these nerve receptors to send a signal to the brain saying, oh, wow, something's going on here. There's some stress down here. And the thing is, there was probably stress to begin with, but the signal wasn't getting through. The muscles were not talking to the brain, or maybe the brain wasn't listening to the muscles. And that may be because people have just overdone this or whatever. But that's the signal we're looking for.
Sorry, Amber, is this something that you're feeling as it's happening? I mean, when you're telling me you're going to push my muscle the other way, it sounds quite painful.
It does sound painful, and some of my clients would definitely agree with you, because in some cases we do have to elicit some pain in order to get the response that we're looking for. But in most cases, it's actually really relaxing. I'm not going to stress it to the point where the muscle's screaming.
Right.
I'm just going to get it to the point where the muscle goes, okay, that's enough. And that's why I need to be in tune too, because everyone has different thresholds. Some people's muscles will allow me to stretch them like way past where other people's would. So you have to kind of be in tune. All we're looking for, though, the simple thing is we just need a little bit of stress. So if someone's got a really tight muscle and I try to stretch that hard, that's going to be painful. But the fact that it's really tight is actually going to work in my favor, because if you think of the muscles as if they're guitar strings, when you think about a really tight guitar string, you just kind of have to tap it and it starts this vibrational effect. Same thing with the muscles, and that's the way it works. So no, it's not painful. It's actually really relaxing. And because we're kind of messing with the brain waves a little bit, it actually does take people to a deep sense of relaxation where, like, they could be mid-conversation, and then I start the treatment, and they just kind of, they lose it. They lose their train of thought, their ability to speak, and they just kind of, they get this little pool of drool on the bed.
I was remembering that when I had my treatment, because the way that you were describing it, I mean, it makes sense to me from a practitioner's standpoint, but I don't remember any pain whatsoever. I definitely remember falling asleep.
You obviously didn't have a pelvic adjustment then, because that's not fun.
I imagine different procedures, have different pain levels.
Every now and then somebody would come out of the room and be looking for Amber, saying, I'm just going to punch her once. But that was pretty rare.
Right. Just once, right?
Yeah.
It's acceptable.
They'd
ask me to hold her down.
Well, and what I was saying was, you have those people come out saying that. However, they come back for their next treatment.
Oh,
they love her. They bring her candy and chocolate.
Oh, gosh. Oh, I forgot about Christmas working there. We'd have so many cookies and it's beautiful.
Yeah, like people are so thankful. The success rate is quite astounding.
Yeah, the success rate's extremely high, especially compared to some of the other types of treatments that are out there. It's, I don't know what the current studies would reveal for chiropractic, but last time I checked, I think it was about 30%, like a 30% improvement rate. And like we're in the high 80s, so don't have the clinical data to back it up. It's amazing. It's really amazing. It's hard to believe for most people, though. Especially when, like, I had a lady, I was just in treatments the day before yesterday, before I left for my trip, and I had a lady that had come in after her first treatment. You could see she came back for her second treatment, and she did not want to be there. She's thinking, these people came in, they touched a few spots on my back and on my legs. They were hardly even in the room, because, of course, we lead the room while we're allowing the muscles to process the information. So she's thinking, they actually charged me $60 for that. She did not notice any results. Unfortunately, not everyone does notice a result after just one treatment. So, but she hung in there. She came back on faith, and she actually shared that story with me, how she was feeling so skeptical and disappointed. But sure enough, because she had hung in there, the next treatment, I was able to do so much more work. You know, if the basic work doesn't help, then we take it up a notch and we get a little bit more invasive. And I mean, she's 80% better.